Dr. Catriona Wallace is the founder of Responsible Metaverse Alliance. That's an organisation dedicated to the responsible development of technology. She joins us now. Catriona, is Sam Altman the good guy or the bad guy?
Well, he's not necessarily good or bad, but he is a technologist. And in my experience of running AI companies, technologists are not incentivised towards ethics. So in that sense, I would suggest he would lean more on the bad guy side.
Well, further to that, Catriona, should we be worried that he's back in charge?
I think we should be extremely worried that Sam Altman is back leading OpenAI. And the reason for that is simply that we feel that the fallout from the board has been the board potentially wanted a slowdown in AI development and a slowdown in work done on the Q star. And Sam Altman, I believe, will not want that slowdown. He'll want to be fast to market to produce product and get that into the mainstream.
So I want to talk about this Q star thing because it sounds like something the evil empire in a science fiction film has. It is apparently something that, well, some fear is too dangerous even to release. Do you know anything about this? Is there any of this that's public?
What we know about QStar is that it's an early stage artificial general intelligence. So it goes well beyond the artificial narrow intelligence that we have now, whereas the current ChatGPT and generative AI is able to do more language and grammar-based models. This one can do mathematics. With a machine being able to do even grade school mathematics, the levels that it can get to with regard to being generally intelligent, which means that it can do more than just a simple single task, it can do a whole range of tasks at some depth, means that this would be the first time we had machines that are genuinely smarter and more capable than humans.
Does that mean, for example, not to put this in apocalyptic terms, actually, you know what, to put it in apocalyptic terms, does that mean it would be a step closer to being able to design its own weaponry, its own bombs, make decisions that would genuinely wipe out human beings? Is it that kind of thing that they're worried about?
It's a step towards that. So let's look at the existential risk that AI currently poses. So if we look at the literature from Oxford University, who study all the different types of existential risk, including nuclear war, solar flares, asteroids, bioengineered pandemics, AI is in fact the number one existential risk that humanity faces, with a 1 in 10 chance that AI will destroy humanity by the end of the century or significantly reduce humanity's potential. So these are some of the most learned academics and researchers. And that's why we saw earlier this year, on two occasions, the leading AI thinkers in the world came out with a request to pause the development of AI and then came out with a statement saying that AI should be regarded in the same level of risk as pandemics and nuclear war. So that's how dangerous this technology can potentially be.
We're all looking at each other here going, oh, my God, really? You're scaring us.
I did a talk at South by Southwest the other week, and one of the panel members asked me, you know, do I think we're doomed? And I said, yes. And the audience nervously laughed. And I said, why are you laughing? And then I could see people realise, right, is she serious? And I said, I am absolutely serious, as are most of the leading thinkers in the world, that AI poses a serious risk to humanity and we have to get onto that right now.
But on the flip side, 10% chance of being wiped out, they're pretty good odds.
Pretty good odds.
Like, 90% chance we'll be okay.
No
Dr.
laughing,
Catriona,
right?
I think that you've delivered sleepless nights for the majority of Australia.
Yeah, I want to go home now. I feel uncomfortable.
Thank you so much for your time, though, Dr. Wallace.
Pleasure.